IRDA has regulated web-based insurance websites to ensure that aggregators do not indulge in promoting products. The insurance regulator has said that the aggregators cannot display ratings, rankings, endorsements, or bestsellers of insurance products on their websites. Ruth Saldana has the story.
Late last month, the insurance regulator IRDA came up with guidelines for web aggregators. Web aggregators are sites that provide information on insurance products from various companies. The information collated can help insurance seekers compare premium rates for health, life, travel and motor insurance. Most portals just generate leads and not all offer the option to purchase a product online. To ensure that aggregators do not indulge in promoting products, the IRDA also banned them from commenting on insurers or their products. But the recent IRDA judgment has generated mixed reactions. Industry players feel that while the aim was to give some sort of regulation for the websites, the guidelines are harmful to consumer interests.
There are some points which are good and fair, and there seems to be a reasoning behind why these regulations have been put in place. But if you look at it from a consumer point of view, it's extremely restrictive. It cuts out a channel which can give free, easy to access, and accessible in a non-intrusive manner information on insurance products to the consumer. That will be completely chopped off. And this is, if you look at it very closely, the only medium available to the consumer today where he can compare. So effectively, the consumer will never be able to compare products across insurance companies.
According to the circular, and I quote, web aggregators shall not display ratings, rankings, endorsements or bestsellers of insurance products on their website. The content of the website of the web aggregators shall be unbiased and factual in nature. They shall desist from commenting on insurers or their products in their editorials or any other location in their websites, end of quote.
Very clearly, the value of a price comparison lies in not just providing the features, benefits and premiums, but also in telling consumers probably which feature, which benefit is important and why, and possibly giving the expert opinion as well as other consumers' feedback on specific products, which could be by way of editorial comments, which can be by way of consumer rating, etc. I think that's a very, very vital part of comparison. And if that is not possible, I think it does a disservice in terms of the consumers being able to take an informed decision.
In the rival mutual fund industry, websites like valueresearchonline.com and morningstarindia.com offer comparative services and rankings and ratings that help consumers pick funds.
It will work exactly in the opposite way that the regulator wants it. It's going to increase the cost of sourcing. Now, the insurance company doesn't do anything different from what we do it. They do the similar thing. So what they were paying, now they will have to end up paying. What we used to do is, we sort of get an interested lead and pass it on to three players. Now, three players, you know, depending on the consumer request, consumer might say, I just want to go to one player. So I actually split the cost into three and let the market efficiencies come into play. Whoever is efficient attacks the customer and gets a conversion out of it. But here, now the insurance company will have to do their sourcing alone. And again, the cost will go up for them. They will have to do open market sourcing, which again, the price will go up from maybe 100 to 200, 250 and 650 per lead, which they could have easily brought it down to one third. So it's going to work exactly the opposite. Pricing, the cost of acquisition for the insurance company just goes up.
Currently, the web aggregation industry is worth about 3 crore rupees a month and growing. Almost 70% of all online sales are done through web aggregators. However, as per the new guidelines, many aggregators may be forced to shut shop. Interestingly, capital markets regulator SEBI in October had proposed that an advisor who recommends investments cannot be the agent who sells them. This was a move to help curb mis-selling. The IRDA guidelines are expected to come into effect by the 1st of February 2012, and aggregators have until then to either change their models or decide on their future course.